More now on mandatory vaccinations and whether children should be forced to roll up their sleeves. We're joined by infectious disease specialist Dr. Nick Coatsworth in Canberra. It's hot in here, Doctor, this morning. Victoria is looking pretty closely at vaccination mandates for those kids between 5 and 11. Front page of the Herald Sun. Your thoughts this morning?
Well, Carl, this is a really difficult part to nuance, isn't it? Because I agree with everything that Senator Jackie Lambie just said regarding vaccine mandates for adults. We have to understand that the equation is different for children because it is milder disease, because there are known side effects, albeit very rare, and the heart inflammation is mild, but it's nonetheless there, which means that parents do have a choice. And, you know, ultimately, if parents don't make the choice to vaccinate their children, I'm not sure that kids should be penalised for that. Some mates that might say that's a bad choice. Yeah. I wouldn't make that choice. I will very likely vaccinate our kids. But I don't think kids of parents who choose not to vaccinate should have their children penalised.
OK, so there's a subtle difference there. So Moderna could soon become available to children as young as 6. What is your message to parents then? Should they wait for more data? What's your thought process?
My message is always going to be advice that I follow, which is if a TAGI says it's OK, they're the ones that have run our childhood immunisation program for decades. They're the ones that make the decisions about chickenpox vaccine or measles vaccine. Yeah. If they say it's OK, it'll be OK. And then we have to educate and convince, but we shouldn't cajole and we shouldn't talk down to parents. I've seen a bit of that from particular states' public health officials, and I'm not sure that that's the way we should do things to convince people to get their children jabbed.
OK, Greg Hunt, meantime, has written to the Queensland government over expensive PCR tests saying it's a waste of time, or effectively those words. Do you think they're needed?
No, they're not needed. I think that rapid antigen tests would be more than sufficient. I think that, you know, getting someone to pay for PCR tests is just an added burden. And to be honest, Carl, let me let you in on a secret. State governments have been doing very well from the federal government out of the Medicare rebates for PCR tests. So it's a little bit astonishing that a government would then go and charge the public for the same sort of PCR tests when they've been getting money from the federal government for them for the past 18 months.
Wow.
So I don't think that that's probably the right way to do things.
So you think it's all about that?
Oh, I think it's a health rule, and I think they legitimately believe in it. Of course they do. They wouldn't bring it in for cost recovery. All I'm saying is that state governments have done very well so far, so they needn't charge the public. If they want to make people do PCR tests to come in, why don't they pay for it themselves?
All right, I think you've got unanimous support for that right across the country. Finally, your thoughts on the push to scrap vaccine mandates, the PM leaving it up to businesses to decide that. What's your thought process on that?
Well, look, my thought process hasn't changed, Carl. I think mandates do serve an important role in our society, but they need to be limited and they can't exclude people from functioning society for a long period of time. So the approach of the New South Wales government to have limited mandates, limited passports to encourage that last 5 or 10%, that's where mandates need to sit. And businesses do have a role, of course, in deciding whether they want to protect their staff from a work health and safety perspective by introducing a mandate.
Dr. Nick Coatsworth, always wonderful to have you on. Thank you.
Tell you what, no one's holding back this morning, are they?